Meryl.
What is it?
Meryl, get down! Meryl! Me they want.
Even I know that. It's the oldest trick in the book. The sniper's using me for bait to lure you out.
Damn.
Shoot me, Snake.
No.
My gun. I can't reach it by myself.
Don't move.
I promised. I wouldn't slow you down. You.
Quiet down. Save your strength.
I was a fool. I wanted to be a soldier. But war is ugly. There's nothing glamorous about it. Snake, please save yourself. Go on living and don't give up on people. Don't forget me. Now get out of here!
Meryl! Damn! Snake, it's a trap. A sniper's trick to lure you out. The sniper's waiting for you to go and help Meryl, so he can pick you off. Don't do it.
Must be Sniper Wolf, Foxhound's best shooter.
Snipers usually work in pairs, but this one's alone, huh?
I know her. She can wait for hours, days, or weeks. It doesn't matter to her. She's just watching and waiting for you to expose yourself.
Maybe so, but Meryl can't hold out that long.
Snake, can you see Wolf from where you are?
There's nowhere to hide between here and the tower. She must be on the second floor of the tower.
If Wolf is in the communications tower, she can see you perfectly. It's the classic sniper's position. At that distance, you won't be able to hit her with a standard weapon either. You'll need a sniper rifle.
Colonel, take it easy. I'm gonna save Meryl, no matter what it takes.
Okay. Thanks.
What's wrong, Naomi?
Nothing. I'm just surprised you're willing to sacrifice yourself. You got the genes of a soldier, not a savior.
You trying to say that I'm only interested in saving my own skin?
I wouldn't go that far, but...
I don't know what the hell my genes look like, and I don't care. I operate on instinct.
Like an animal?
I'm going to save Meryl. I don't need an excuse.
Okay.
And I'm not doing it for someone else, either. I'm gonna save Meryl for myself. Colonel, don't worry.
Snake, thanks.
I understand. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Sniper Wolf is Foxhound's best sharpshooter. Everyone knows that women have more patience than men, but Sniper Wolf can go for a whole week with no sleep, no food, and her sights never straying from her target. And on top of that, she takes diazepam, so her hands never tremble.
Stay out of her range and shoot at her with a sniper rifle.
Yeah, but where can I find a sniper rifle? I can't ask Meryl.
What about Dr. Emmerich? He's been on the base for a while. He might know.
Otacon, have you ever seen a sniper rifle anywhere on this base?
A sniper rifle?
Meryl's been shot by an extremely good sniper.
Sniper?
A high-quality sniper rifle is the only way I can fight back.
I saw a PSG-1 in the armory in the second floor basement of the tank hangar.
The second floor basement of the tank hangar? I have to go all the way back there?
Well, yeah.
What's wrong with you, Otacon?
Nothing.
Otacon, where is there a sniper rifle?
There's a PSG-1 in the armory in the second floor basement of the tank hangar.
The most important tools you need to be a good sniper are the senses that you were born with. No amount of training can change those. If your senses are dull from the beginning, you'll never be a great sniper.
You cannot win without a sniper rifle. You cannot save the girl either. Find a sniper rifle. It is the only way to save Meryl.
Didn't you just hear that there's a sniper rifle in the second floor basement of the tank hangar? Go get it and save Meryl.
Thank you. Mr. Box.
Against Sniper Wolf. Hurry up and save Merrill.
What was that noise?
PSG-1. You can use that against Sniper Wolf. Hurry up and save Meryl.
Get on your stomach. Fire from the prone position. It would be good if you had a tripod or something stable to balance your weapon on. If you do not have that, hold the weapon firmly under your armpit and keep it still with your chin. Line up your target in your scope's crosshairs.
The SWAT manual, the longest a shooter can stay adequately focused on his target is 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, the observer and the shooter change places. Sniping is usually a two-man job.
What is it?
Wolf, I just forget it.
Thank you.
stay out of her range and shoot at her with a...
The tranquilizer that Worf is using is diazepam.
Diazepam?
It's benzodiazepam-based anti-anxiety drug. It has a strong effect on the central nervous system and it's often used as a psychotropic drug.
So how does it stop your hands from trembling?
Anti-anxiety drugs are also effective as muscle relaxants. They're widely used to treat psychosomatic disorders such as autonomic ataxia or as pre-anesthetics to relax patients before an operation.
I see.
But be careful. If diazepam is used in large doses over a long period of time, it becomes addictive like alcohol. An adult should take no more than 1 to 4 doses per day, with each dose being 0.25 to 0.5 milligrams each.
Jeez, you sound like a doctor.
I am a scientist.
Good job with Worf. Is Meryl okay?
I don't know. I don't see her around.
You don't think she's been captured, do you?
Could be. Let's ask Worf. If she's still alive, I'm gonna get some answers.
Snake.
About Meryl. I'm counting on you. Snake, take the underground passage north.
You need to make snap decisions. In war, the difference between living and dying is counted in milliseconds.
In the 20th century, in order to be a military superpower, you had to first be an economic superpower. But things changed toward the end of the century, after the collapse of communism. With all the surplus weapons and technology floating around, even economically weak countries could have a powerful military. According to the military doctrine, which is the basis for NATO expansion, a preemptive nuclear strike may be undertaken if there is a sufficient threat of a regional conflict spreading to a large-scale war. In the face of all this NATO expansion, Russia might feel the need to flex their nuclear muscles, if only to show NATO that even with their aging arsenal and diminished army, they are still a major power. Russia could no longer pay enough money to its leading scientists, so they sold their weapons and weapons technology to the highest bidders. NBC weapons flowed into the hands of dictators and terrorists. The military balance of the world crumbled. The world has never seen the balance of power shift so quickly and dramatically. The first subcritical test was performed on July 2nd, 1997.